This time we'll stand for the invocation and pledge of allegiance. Father, thank you for this day and all the blessings that you've given us, and be with us as we conduct the city business, and be with each and every one here, and be with us as we go our separate ways. For it's in Christ's name we pray. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You may be seated. The purpose of this meeting is for the board to consider employment firm that has come forward that has worked with me over the last couple of days and looking into what the possibility of selecting this firm for to help us in a search for new city manager. This is a local firm. Myself personally, this guy is very well thought of in our community, and I wanted to give him this opportunity to meet with the board, see what you guys think about what kind of process that he and his staff have put together that can aid us into the location and the hiring of a new city manager. Also, I will point out in the beginning that he is willing to donate his services with the exception of what it would cost the city and the posting of these, and that'll be pointed out in his proposal. There would be no finder's fee associated with this if this firm is selected. So at this time, I want to recognize Joey Martin with Express Employment here in Texarkana, Arkansas.
Thank you, Mayor. Thank you, Councilman. I know most of you appreciate the opportunity to come forward. I'll give each one of y'all a packet. Know you well. Don't say the bad thing. First of all, my name is Joey Martin. I am owner of Express Employment Professionals here in Texarkana and a resident of Texarkana, Arkansas for the last 24 years. Many of you that I've worked with and know me, I'm pretty active in the community and with our schools and the Chamber of Commerce, Workforce Development, and Economic Development. I'm here today to offer any and all services that my business Express may be able to help with the city of Texarkana, Arkansas and your city manager search. If Mayor Brown and the board of directors see fit, we would like to volunteer our services towards the city for this search. Anything we can do to help our community that's been so good to us, both personally and professionally, would be an honor and privilege. And I mean that with my deepest sincerity. We know in our business, in staffing and recruiting, the task at hand is critical and very difficult. In this scenario that I'll go through, I'm proposing that Express Employment would provide the administration of the ad placing and replying to candidates with questions that will be approved by the board of directors and the mayor. And those questions, as they come in, we'll go through that. And we'll present that information to the appointed city personnel or the board. Any advertising costs, like the mayor pointed out, was from the selected recruiting sites that will pass, that cost will pass through to the city at our cost. As a franchise owner in the Express Employment Network, we have over 800 franchises. And as a business that's been here for 32 years, I feel we have the resources and that could help the city through this hiring process. I have outlined how that process could assist the city, and I will go over that. To all of you as a business owner, again, as a citizen of this city, I deeply appreciate all the things y'all do. You have accomplished in our city the great things, and I look forward to the future. The future of Texarkana, Arkansas is very bright. So that next page, I kind of went through a step by step to go through, and you can stop me, question me, whatever you want, anytime. I'll refer to Express Employment as, or the EEP in the proposal as Express. Express will obtain a recruit. recruitment advertisement for the city manager, and that's coming from the city, from you guys. Express will obtain a job description for the city manager also. That will be so when we have communication, we need to be as educated as possible to qualifications and requirements. We'll post that to the following state and national recruiting sources. Indeed, LinkedIn, Strategic Government Resources Job Board, governmentjobs.com, International City County Management Association, the Arkansas Municipal League, the Texas Municipal League, GovHR USA, Careers in Government, Glassdoor, Town and City Manager Jobs, and that cost, we have done our research, and if we post this job to all those sites, that's a $968 cost that, as we said, we would pass through to the city. We will receive all the responses, the resumes, the letters, and we will go through a qualifications process, and that will be what y'all approve to us, qualifications. All applicants, whoever applies, whether they're qualified or non-qualified, will be submitted to the City of Texarkana, Arkansas Personnel Department, as required by law as well. Express will then contact the qualified candidates that have met the qualifications y'all have given to us, and we'll ask a first set of questions. Okay? These questions will be approved, designed by you guys. All we're going to do is administer them. But I put some suggested questions in here. Tell us your background, personally and professionally. How does your work experience qualify you for the city manager job? Does your experience in budget preparations and management of finance describe your experience, in budget preparations and management of finances? Share your experience in strategic planning. What is your community involvement? And again, I say those are all can be picked, chosen, thrown out by you guys. Express, we will review the qualified applicant responses. Responses will be forwarded to the City of Texarkana, Arkansas Personnel Administrator, which will confidentially distribute to the mayor and the board of directors as see fit. The mayor and the board of directors will conduct a meeting of review. The board of directors and mayor will inform the personnel administrator of candidates that y'all want us to go further with. Okay? That's the resource we bring to y'all. This is inundated with a lot of communication, a lot of documentation, and in the end, we're going to walk in with a packet and say they qualified, and here's their responses. Then y'all direct us from there. Some questions maybe for the second phase. Describe your leadership style. Explain how you see a manager's role on a team. How would you handle a budget shortfall? Tell of a rough decision you had to make and your involvement in governmental affairs. Then we will then provide the city administrator, personnel administrator, with the responses from that second phase of question results. Again, that's going to be a packet hand delivered, and the city personnel administrator will take it from there and distribute it to the mayor and the board of directors. The board of directors will meet and notify the personnel administrator of the selected candidates. Okay, at that point, we're thinking y'all got somebody that y'all like their first responses of questions, second response of questions. So now we want to talk to them. You guys want to talk to them. Y'all will notify us of the date and the times that accommodate the board and the mayor, and we will set those travel accommodations up, and we will bill y'all for that at cost. The decision to hire a candidate from the pool of qualified applicants, for city manager will lie solely with the Texarkana Arkansas Board of Directors. We, Express, has nothing to do with selection or opinion. Okay? We do get in here and, we at the times with clients will talk and say, well, this one sure has a certain personality or that, but that's all for you guys. Okay? We're recruiters and administrators. When candidate is chosen by the city, then it goes through the city's process, the normal hiring process, which I assume is your background checks, your drug testing, your bondability, et cetera. Okay. Does anybody have any questions on the process?
One clarification, I think this is correct. They will actually, if whatever questions we approve of, they will actually respond to those in writing. You won't be actually doing a kind of a phone interview
one thing of us is interpretation or opinion. We're going to be communicating. They'll do the questions. We'll talk to them, send you a series of questions.
Mark, would, is there going to be a, like a resume process as well that they attach with any of this? Or is that going to be after we narrow it down as far as, you know, education, stuff like that?
Yeah, it usually comes with when they see the advertisement, they'll respond, attach the resume with, you know, the comments, and then we'll review the resume and comment back to them and set up a time to converse.
Gotcha, and then that would be forwarded to the board as well?
Yeah, it'll be in the packet.
Okay.
If that's a non-qualified candidate, applicant based on y'all's qualifications, that stack, it'll go in this stack. If we go further with the questions, it'll go in this stack, and then everything will be presented to you.
And a non-qualified applicant, the way I understand it, would be somebody that applied that didn't meet our original criteria of the ad. If we require 5 years of continuous employment, a bachelor in public administration and or equivalent, if they don't meet that, then they apply. But the law requires us to maintain that application as well. So Melissa, as a personnel administrator, would differentiate for those two, but we would never see the non-qualified applicant.
Right, she will have those on file.
She has to keep those on file for certain.
Those will just come to Melissa, and both the non-qualified will have two-step.
Gotcha.
Mr. Martin,
yes, sir.
To emphasize, I guess, for national in-state inquiry, is that how this is gonna go out? It's gonna be national and statewide?
These websites are national. They will go, you know, they're websites on the internet, some of specifically for certain areas, Texas municipality, and then Arkansas. And then the websites are specific for these types of nonprofit management jobs.
So for these researches, it can go on 3 months or 6 months. So your company is willing to endure it through the long haul?
Yeah, I mean, I'll just be upfront. The reason I thought that I wanted to help, I think people will speak a little bit about that, but I thought we could help is because my time in the chamber throughout that, I have went through a turnover in the chamber president. And through that process, we had to select a search firm. We met with them. Well, we had to schedule, and we had to meet. We met, and then we chose, and then they started bringing candidates in through that, and that was back in early 2000. And with our technology and the way it is now, I mean, we recruit for, introduce Heather, she's our recruiter, and I'll elaborate on her. Have we ever recruited or placed a city manager? No. Okay, but the way the recruiting world is today, I feel very confident that we can identify or get their attention and then discuss that with them and then bring that to you guys, you know, after we've asked the screening questions. In your packet also, I say we haven't done a city manager position. We are in this community, we place mechanical engineers, plant managers, accounting managers, controllers, auditors, chief financial officers, IT technicians, human resources, plant controllers, staff accountant, director of partner development. And we're able to do that because of the technology and the world we live in today.
Of course.
And so I sat in with the people at the search firm that we selected at the chamber. And, you know, been in the business for, I think, almost 20 years since then, 18. And I just feel like with the resources that we have, we make it be a benefit to you guys. And
Are you saying you wanna go into executive session?
We can't because it didn't call for the commission, but it's still just on for this, so technically you cannot do executive session, based on what was submitted. It was only the thing just for the hearing and some information I would like to give before we were based on names I would be using. And technically, you can't do that in open session, so.
Can I ask you a question as far as, are there names that you would think would be interested in the job?
No, it don't have nothing to do with.
People that you think would be interested in helping hire them?
No, it don't have nothing to do with this. It has something to do with this, but the name of people that I have been involved with searches and selecting a city manager, and I don't wanna give their name out in public. I would prefer to go behind closed doors and discuss it among y'all and tell what you should expect and make what you shouldn't expect and like that, but, and I don't wanna do it in public.
Let me ask the city attorney.
Yeah, the reason that I would caution against it tonight, one is yours, I understand that, but the bigger one would be to get a good understanding of what you're gonna talk about to make sure there wasn't an inadvertent violation of the public meetings laws. And to make sure that what the board would do in executive session is proper for that purpose. And just listening now, I can't determine that.
Right, and it would be a violation of the meeting because it doesn't say executive session for what's gonna be asked for.
I think too, for clarification purposes, is so everybody's on the same page. When we get into this process, regardless of what process we use, when we actually get into the nuts and bolts of candidates' names and information, et cetera, that will all be discussed in executive session. And there will be several meetings going forward as to how we're going to start reviewing those. And I would just say from my experience with personnel too, and I'm sure everybody understands this, that those will be held in the utmost of confidence, especially with those people applying for jobs. I would not want anybody to know that at that time. But all those sessions will be held in executive session, whether we vote or not vote. We would do that in public at that time. But any other, how does the board, does anybody have any other statements as to how the board would like to proceed?
I just have in general here, because I know that there's been conversation about everything up to this point. At what point would citizens know what's going on? I mean, would they not know until the new director is, the new city manager is announced?
It would be my understanding that we would probably release that when we narrow this to say three candidates. That's my experience. It's when we get down to the point where we've named finalists, like UACCH, Hope Texarkana just announced their finalists. It would be that similar procedure where you wouldn't know every candidate, but you would have knowledge of who the three were that were, and we would have their permission. I did serve on the search committee for that, and you get their permission to release their name as a finalist, and that's when that would occur. It would be down to however many we chose to be finalists. Yes?
We have a meeting on the 16th. Can we just be on the agenda on the 16th?
The 16th, you mean the 19th?
No, I said the 19th.
19th, it's put on the agenda for what, for this?
Yeah, still voting tonight, and then we can maybe do it, the last item right after that session on the 19th.
I mean, I have no problem with that if that's the board's desire. We've not heard from any boards how you would like to proceed with Joy. Would you like to postpone it tonight? I mean, I'm Director Harris and am willing to take a shot and not waste another 2 weeks and get this, let him pursue getting this ad out there. I don't think we're losing anything. It doesn't say we have to hire anybody that he's presenting before us. It doesn't say we can have to change the process on down the road, but.
Mayor, I'm willing to move forward with the selection of the search committee tonight. I'm ready to make that motion.
Same here. If there's nothing that's going to be illegal to us proceeding.
Absolutely not. Not for number one.
No, I mean, just going forward like this, no. Again, just going forward, we have to be careful and talk to Mr. Martin about the Freedom of Information Act and comply with the same.
So, just to be clear, Director Hart, you would make a motion to engage the services of Express Employment for the purpose of soliciting applicants for a city manager position. You would have to include in that motion to authorize the city to spend up to $1,000. As we get through this, the way I see this going, that would just get the process going. Then as we get through this process, if we're interested in interviewing candidates and we have to pay expenses of that candidate, We're authorizing him, in my opinion, to work with our personnel administrator, Melissa, and he's using his experience to tweak our ad. These ads will go to his employment agency, not to the city, so they have some things to do with that. But that's basically what I'm saying, is what your motion would be, is to authorize us to start and to authorize the city to spend up to $1,000.
So my motion is to select Express Personnel as our search committee with the authority to spend up to $1,000 for those ads, and to act on behalf of the city in that selection process and working with our HR manager, and then helping to get those applicants narrowed down to where they're brought before the board.
Okay, I see. So we have a motion and a second. Is there any other discussion? Just a minute.
Ask a question.
Yeah, just a minute. So is there any other discussion from the board?
We'll have the questions to him with maybe within the next couple of weeks.
I would suggest that we all submit questions to him. We can maybe do that by email. The issue would be, in my experience would be, we don't want to inundate them.
Sure.
Four or five questions that we can use to try to just get the ball rolling. And I can tell you, when you get to the interview process, you can ask them anything you want. And we can ask them as many questions as we want. But this should give us an idea of, I like some of his question personally myself, to try to learn. My intent would be to try to learn something about that person without seeing them and talking with them as to how they would handle the job as city manager. So I would suggest that be thinking about, make this as condensed as possible.
So Joey, just to be clear, we would be working directly with Heather.
Heather and I.
And you too.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Heather
will be handling the majority of the traffic, right? Okay.
And our go-between will not be me, will not be you. It will be Melissa as a personnel administrator and distributing these packets to us. I'll see those packets. You'll see those packets. We'll all see them at the same time. We haven't discussed this, but we discussed how many are we going to collect before we start meeting. And I would say at least 3 to 4. When you get at least 3 or 4 or 5 candidates, you need to start distributing that to us so that you can spend some time looking at it. Doesn't say we have to move on with them.
Yep.
Doesn't say we have to interview anybody. But once you have 3 or 4, I would say we need to move on.
I agree.
And at least start looking at it.
I agree.
Okay. All right. Any other discussion? Director Harris.
Yes, apparently. And I guess I could always say, try not to put names in. I've been up on this, two times with the school board. Done
anytime.
No hard feelings.
You betcha. Anytime any of y'all think that we're not a resource, I want you to quit the right resource.
Okay. You're a great resource.
And the only other comment I would make is a couple of points that you made. One is, yes, this is an opportunity not only use a Texarkana, Arkansas business that's rooted in our community that knows our people.
That's
right. It's also not a chance to save quite a bit of money than hiring some big time search firm. And the second thing would be is, I would think probably legally we could check with personnel and maybe even with George, and that would be, if you're going to take this position, you're going to have a required background check, a required bondability. Those things just go with the territory and the being in this type of position. So I think that would be a requirement. They'll sign the necessary documentation before we reach out to them, before they would be employed. So that's going to be a requirement to do that. All right, any other comments before voting? At this time, is there anyone from the public that wishes to speak before we vote? David, please keep your comments addressed to this particular instance that refers to this firm.
Yes, sir. I just have 2 points and then the question. One is, we've worked with the company before. We've got good people and we've got bad people, but it's not reflection on them. It's reflection on the people that sometime come. The other thing is, sometime when you get a lot of different applications, they can become confusing. A lot of you guys have been in that hiring process. It may be that when you give your instructions, you create some type of point system, so at least you know who's in the higher range and who's in the lower range, because they can all blur together. But my question is, as you give them instructions, what attributes will you be looking for, and what attributes will you not be looking for in a city manager?
That's just based on the credentials to get the job. That's to get the process going right now, is to require what we've normally required in the past, and that's a minimum of years of experience and a certain education background, and that gets the process rolling. Those attributes will come amongst all of these board members as we interview these candidates.
So does any of the board members have any comments on that?
Yes, you know, we don't have all the job descriptions and duties and responsibilities, you know, listed right here in front of us. You know, those will be really taking, you know, front stage as far as selecting, you know, that candidate. Like I said, we don't have all those questions answered right in front of us, but that's what we'll be looking for.
Are there any personal attributes more so than the technical?
I don't think we can discuss those at this time.
When you talk about personal, you mean
how they are.
Right. Gotcha.
Any other person wish to speak prior to the board voting? If not, could you call the roll, please?
Brewer?
Yes.
Miner?
Yes.
Hart?
Yes.
Roberts?
Yes.
Harris?
Yes.
Brown?
Yes. So the motion carries. Joey, congratulations. We're looking forward to working with you. I appreciate your time and effort you're going to put into this, and I appreciate you coming forward and offering to do this for us.
Just to clarify that we will work with Alyssa, okay? And we worked with her several times. We'll get that as soon as we can get the job, the recruiting and design, we'll send it back for the approval. That'll go post, and then from there we will be.
I can email Melissa tomorrow. I can call her and just let her know what
she's got. My email contact.
And you just can contact her and get the job ad written, is what I would do. And just head out, and good luck to us all.
Good luck to everybody.
Thanks again.
Okay. Prior to adjournment, interim city manager David Hake has asked to address the board for just one quick response.
Thank you, Mayor, City Board. As a point of personal privilege, first of all, let me say thank you for what you've just done, okay? And I think you couldn't have picked anybody that's better than Joey and his team. I really do. I'm glad that they're local and they're part of Texarkana, Arkansas. And on behalf of David Hake, Joey, could you find someone by tomorrow? So anyway. But the real reason I came up here is that I made a change to the agenda. It was pointed out to me that it was beyond my authority, and I didn't know it, but if I got this today after that, and I want to apologize to the board and to the citizens say this, I am a novice. I was just called in to try to keep it going straight. This is a difficult job and you need a professional. And so thank you for your action tonight. And I'm sorry for any inconvenience on that one thing.
Thank you, David.
Thank you. All right, knowing of any other business, make a motion, I would entertain a motion to adjourn.
Motion to adjourn.
Second.